Luke Walton's done. I think this is going to be his last season in L.A. I don't think it's deserved. I'm not an advocate of Luke Walton being gone, but I think that everybody sees the handwriting on the wall. There's just too much stuff going on. LeBron's not going to say anything, but everybody and their mother knows that LeBron James would prefer that Ty Lue was the new coach of the Los Angeles Lakers. That's the name that I've been hearing. I don't think Magic Johnson will bring him on board, but I think if LeBron James and his camp had their druthers, it would be Ty Lue. Let me just throw that out there right now.
And when Luke Walton this morning.
Go ahead, please.
And by the way, the last several weeks, all I've been hearing from you, and the reason I said, Molly, go to Stephen A. first, is closer. LeBron needs a closer. That's all you've been religiously preaching. Closer, closer, closer.
Yeah, I mean, you know, don't get me wrong. You're not wrong. I just forgot that I was using that word because I might not remember what I said at 7:30 this morning when I was half asleep or whatever the case may be. But you're right. I've been saying that for months now, and I maintain that. But that's not to imply that LeBron can't close. It's to imply that the pieces around him ain't going to cut it. Kyle Kuzma is a third wheel at best. Ideally, that's where you want him to be. I'm not sold on anybody else there. And when you look at LeBron and his age and the mileage on his body and the load that he has to carry, the reality is you need shot makers and you need somebody to hand the ball to and be able to say, take me there. So he definitely needs that. But he also needs a coach that he believes in, that everybody believes in. Now, LeBron ain't going behind Luke Walton's back, talking mess about him, want him gone or anything like that. But anytime there's trepidation or apprehension about Luke Walton, you don't hear LeBron speaking up on his behalf. You've never heard that. You know, certainly don't hear anybody in his camp speaking up on Luke Walton's behalf. So we understand what's going on here. Not to mention the fact Luke Walton was not hired by Irvin Magic Johnson. Magic Johnson did not make that call. That's not his guy. So he's going to give him a chance, all right? He's going to evaluate things at the end of the season. But with all the things that have been transpiring, unless a tremendous run takes place the rest of this regular season and into the playoffs, I think there's going to be a new head coach in L.A. next year. And I'm sad about it because I don't want Luke Walton gone. I think he deserves a better chance with a better roster before that determination is made personally. But I don't know if that'll happen.
I don't think what LeBron most needs is a coach. I think Luke Walton is a good coach.
So do I.
Whether or not he's a great coach, time will tell. But he's at least a good coach. And I don't think LeBron needs a closer. I think LeBron with the ball in his hand is at the end of the game is going to make the right decision with the ball. Not like in the first finals against Dallas playing hot potato. Not because it's the right basketball play, but because he wants to abdicate responsibility. No. If he needs to score, he'll score. If he needs to knock down a free throw, I think he'll do that. If he needs to set up an open teammate, he'll make the right basketball play at the end of the game. I don't think he needs a closer. He needs other all-stars on the team. You are not going to beat the Golden State Warriors without another all-star. In fact, you're not going to beat the Golden State Warriors with KD if that team stays together with just one other all-star. You would preferably need another MVP-caliber player plus another all-star plus other useful players, but at least two other all-stars. And look at who's available. And, guys, even if he strikes out.
Look at that class. That is unreal.
They could whiff on every one of those guys. You know who else could opt out at the end of this season? Chris Middleton. If the Lakers even just picked up Chris Middleton and saved cap space for Anthony Davis next year, there's a team, and you hold on to your young talent that would beat the Warriors. I'm telling you right now, I don't care who they keep. How about this, Stephen A.? If you can't even get Chris Middleton, but you can add smart pieces at the right price, like Mirotić or Marcus Morris or Danny Green, preparing the stage, setting the stage for AD the following year, that's a team that might be able to beat the Warriors.
Well, let me challenge your thought process in that. First of all, I don't want to hear those names at the expense of the free agent class that's coming up. You're never going to see, I won't say never, but you'll be hard-pressed to find a free agent class more potent than the one that's coming up this summer. All right, so let's put that out there. If you are LeBron James, you ain't asking cats to come to Lake Erie, man. You asking cats to come to L.A., La La, palm trees, sunshine, the beautiful weather, all of this stuff. If you can't get cats to come to L.A. with cap space and you already being there, that is a blemish on LeBron James. Let's get that right out the way. This is the trade and deadline. Ain't got nothing to do with him. But free agency this summer, in terms of recruitment, you got to get something done. I don't want to hear anything about the Chris Middletons. I'm not saying they can't play. I understand Morris and Middleton. These brothers can play. Please don't get me wrong. But because of the potency of the free agent class, combined with the fact that it's LeBron James that's recruiting you, and he's got Magic and L.A. as his backdrop, there is no excuse.
Well, here's
for the
Los
Angeles Lakers
you made the excuse already.
To end up empty-handed this summer.
You made
There's
the excuse,
no excuse
already. The other players are in their feelings about LeBron being bigger and better than them. That's
yeah, get over
the
it.
Excuse.
I'm saying figure out a way around it. That's
but
I'm not
what
denying
I'm
that. I'm
this.
Saying figure it out. But you got to figure out a way to get around that.
Anthony Davis doesn't feel that way, but obviously the league's not going to let him go to L.A. I mean, it's pretty clear
this
that
is there's what I told
that,
you.
That right? Okay, so they're going to have to wait until AD's a free agent and he signs with the Lakers. So you need to keep that cap space available, be flexible with one-year deals, etc. In the meantime, maybe a better idea than just pushing your chips to the middle of the table on players that really aren't going to get you over the top and prevent you from signing AD. You choose one star player,
but that's
even if they're
time.
Not MVP, like a Middleton, to
right?
add to LeBron.
But that's time. And the reason why I got a problem with you in the time stuff, you know what, Max? Once upon a time, your back didn't hurt, bro. Once upon a time, you were healthy. You were walking. You were running. You were rapping. You were doing everything. But suddenly, you've got limitations because you know what? Father time didn't just creep up on you. You know how it happens. You woke up one morning and said, damn, my back. I'm just not what I used to be. That's what you did. I mean, my LeBron ain't getting any younger.
This is not
I mean,
part
we
of
talk
the
about
argument.
Modern.
I know.
He's averaging 38 minutes a game for his career. He's not getting any younger, Max. You
this
can't anticipate 2 years from now that it's just going to be like that.
I
you got to go
not
up and down.
Of,